Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Dr. Mozam Tivana, and in today's class we are going to talk about the Rake Receiver in 3G WCDMA. First question is that why do we need the Rake Receiver in WCDMA or 3G? One of the obvious problems of the wireless communication is the multipath propagation phenomena. And what is that? For example, this base station or node B wants to send some information to this mobile station, so it would have the same information would have multiple copies. For example, the same signal would reach this mobile through a path having a minimum delay of T naught, and then there will be another copy of the same signal that would reach this mobile after a time delay of T1, because it is a longer path. And then would have another signal that would reach this mobile station after a delay of T2, and then T3, which is the longest path. So, but for example, after some time this mobile station sends another signal to this mobile station, for example, and then that signal would also have the multipaths. For example, this is the signal that it received after minimum delay, and then these are the its echoes or copies. So we can see that this signal that was previously received is going to interfere with this signal that is received after some times, and this would lead to distortion of our signal, and we call it as the ISI or inter-symbol interference. And of course, we don't want this ISI or inter-symbol interference, and in order to counter the effect of this ISI, we use the Rake Receiver. So what does this Rake Receiver do? This is the circuit diagram of the Rake Receiver, and here we are getting a signal coming from three multipaths. We have three multipaths of the same signal here. For example, this is signal number one. This is the same signal having the second copy of the same signal, and this is the third copy of the same signal. So the purpose of the searcher is to determine what is the time delay between these copies of the signal. For example, between these two copies, how much is the time difference, and between the second and third copy of the same signal, how much is the time difference. So after that, the first signal would basically be received by the finger circuit number one, second signal would be received by the finger circuit number two, and the third signal would be received by the finger circuit number three. And based upon the input of the searcher, basically the calculation block would calculate that how much it needs to delay the first copy and the second copy so that it can combine them into a more powerful signal using the combiner block. So we need to delay the first copy by this much time and the second copy by this much time in order to combine them as one signal. And we can see that this combined signal is much better than the signal that we received here. So using the Rake Receiver, we have basically countered the effect of multipath propagation, which is leading to the distortion in the signal. Apart from that, Rake Receiver has some other uses as well. For example, thanks to the finger circuits, it is possible that a 3G WCDMA mobile can connect to multiple channels. For example, a mobile can use a voice channel, a data channel at the same time. thanks to these finger circuits. And similarly, when a mobile is doing soft handover in the 3G, it is connected to two mobiles at a time during the procedure of the soft handover. It is connected to two node Bs at a time during the procedure of the handover. And why is that possible? That is possible due to the soft handover phenomena. So thanks for being patient, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. This is it for now.